Clinical classification of jaundice, hemolytic, hepatocellular, and obstructive. A. Intrahepatic, medical. B. Extrahepatic, surgical. Jaundice is described clinically as mild, 6 mg/dL, moderate, 6-15 mg/dL, and severe, 15 mg/dL. Jaundice may also be classified by chemical nature of bilirubin, conjugated and unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia. Features of hemolytic jaundice. Acoluric urine, i.e., freshly passed urine is of normal color as there is absence of bilirubin in urine. Unconjugated urine is not water soluble, but if the urine sample is kept for some time, it turns dark yellow due to conversion of urobilinogen to urobilin, by oxidation. Stool is high colored due to excess amount of stercobilinogen and stercobilin. Jaundice is usually mild and there is lemon yellow tinge of bulbar conjunctiva. Serum bilirubin is usually less than 6 mg/dL and predominantly of unconjugated variety. Anemia, mild, moderate, or severe, according to the degree of hemolytic process. Splenomegaly, very characteristic, spleen is the slaughterhouse of RBC in hemolysis. The patient may have typical facies, example chipmunk facies in thalassemia. Reticulocytosis. Normally bilirubin cannot be detected in urine. Urochrome and uroerythrin are the pigments which give normal urine its characteristic color. Urinary urobilinogen, detected by Ehrlich-Sialdehyde test, and fecal stercobilinogen excretion per day are 1 to 3.5 mg and 40 to 280 mg respectively. Features of obstructive jaundice. Urine, deep yellow or mustard oil-like color, due to presence of conjugated bilirubin. Stool, pale or clay-colored, china clay, with steatorrhea. Steatorrhea means frothy, bulky, pale, offensive, soft, greasy stool which floats on the water of the pan and is difficult to flush from the pan due to absence of bile pigment in the stool. Jaundice, usually deep jaundice and the bulbar conjunctiva turns greenish yellow due to oxidation of bilirubin to biliverdin, green. Jaundice is gradually progressive or fluctuating. Serum bilirubin is usually very high and predominantly of conjugated variety. Generalized pruritus with scratch marks and shiny nails, bile acids irritate the free nerve endings. Sinus bradycardia, probably bile salts, directly inhibit the sinoatrial node. Xanthalasma around the eyes or xanthoma in the knees, buttocks, may be seen due to hypercholesterolemia. Petechiae, purpura, or ecchymosis are seen due to vitamin K deficiency. Lack of bile salts produces vitamin K malabsorption as it is a fat-soluble vitamin. Gallbladder, may be palpable. This indicates the site of obstruction in the bile duct and is usually due to carcinoma of the head of pancreas, not due to cholelithiasis, according to Courvoisier's law. Prolonged obstructive jaundice may produce osteomalacia, bone pain, bone fracture, or night blindness due to vitamin D, or a deficiency respectively, due to malabsorption or steatorrhea. These type of bony changes in obstructive jaundice is known as hepatic osteodystrophy. Rarely, there may be hepatosplenomegaly. History of fever with chill and rigor, and pain abdomen may be present due to cholangitis. There may be abdominal pain in cholelithiasis. Features of chronic cholestasis are pruritus with scratch marks, xanthoma, bruising, and bone pain. Features of hepatocellular jaundice. Urine, yellowish. Stool, high-colored and becomes pale if there is obstruction due to cellular, hepatocytes, edema. Orange-yellow tinge of the bulbar conjunctiva, conjugated unconjugated bilirubin. Anorexia, nausea, vomiting, fever with chill and rigor may be present before the appearance of jaundice, e.g. in viral hepatitis. Tender hepatomegaly is frequent. Variable pruritus. There may be bleeding manifestations as a result of hepatocellular failure. There may be H/O affection of other members of the family or locality, viral hepatitis, drug intake, rifampicin, or poisoning, copper sulfate.